Let me show you how to solve the vehicle routing problem with time windows in Java using our open source solver, Timefold. So you go to the website timefold.ai and you click on the button to go to our Quickstarts repository. This repository has a number of examples you can just run immediately on your system and you can tailor to your need and customize to your needs. So if we go to the use cases directory, and we scroll down to vehicle routing with time windows, you can see we have more quick starts examples in here, such as school time tabling, order picking, food packaging, and so forth. Well, we take the one with vehicle routing, one with time windows in this case. You can see screenshots of the demo UI, and you can also find the instructions to run this on your machine right now. And that's exactly what I'll be doing right now. So we take the, we clone the Timefold quick starts repository. And then we go into that directory of this example. And then we run Maven Quarkus dev to run it immediately on our system using Maven, using Quarkus. Now, we can also use, instead of Maven, Gradle, of course, not for this example, but we have some of the other examples showing you how you would set that up. And of course, you could use Spring instead of Quarkus. We have another example which has does everything in Spring. And you can easily actually take this example and transform this to Spring if you would want to do that. So I've cloned the Timefold Quickstarts repository, and in here you can see we have the use cases directory, and in the use cases directory we have that example of a vehicle routing with time windows. So let's go in there, let's go to use cases, let's go to vehicle routing with time windows, and let's start this up with Maven Quarkus dev in Maven Quarkus dev mode. So the dev mode will allow me to make changes and immediately see those changes on the screen, right? So let's go to localhost. I'm going to my browser. I'm going to localhost 8080. Wait a second till it starts up. And it starts to, it's started up. Here we have the demo. Right. So in here, we need to deliver, we actually need to visit a number of these locations across the country. And we need to perform a service there. So think about field service technician routing, for example, to install cables in people's homes, or to maybe to paint the homes, or whatever the case may be, right? And so we need to make sure that we arrive there within the time window of the customer. So for example, imagine somebody needs to come to your house. They've actually told you that they will be there in the morning. So then we need to arrive between 8 a.m. and between 12, between 8 a.m. and noon, basically, right? If they would say I arrive in the afternoon, and we shouldn't be showing up in the morning. Right. So let's solve this. And now we're going to look for the most efficient path to visit all of these locations with one of our vehicles, but to make sure we arrive there at the correct time. And you can see here at the top, this is the amount of time it takes. It takes 25 hours in total for all of these vehicles total. Some of these, and some you can see the average driving time of these vehicles is now 3 hours to 5 hours and things like that. In a more elaborate data set, you would probably see more like 8 hours, and you would also would add a constraint that says the vehicle should not be working more than 8 or 9 hours, depending on the case in the country and stuff like that. Okay, we have a solution here. So let's take a look how that looks like by vehicle. So we can see on the map how the vehicles are driving from the depots. But if you actually look at here, look at it here per vehicle, you can see that vehicle one is leaving from depot, traveling for some time, but the first customer of that technician, in this case, the first customer is called Hugo, the technician arrives too early, and they need to wait until the time window actually starts. And that's the blue time you can see here. Then he performs a service there, for example, fixes the internet, whatever the case may be. And then he or she travels to the next location and performs a service there, and so forth and so forth. And as you can see, during the afternoon, we have too few jobs to actually fill that all up, and then we just have to wait until the new time window opens to do all of the work in the afternoon. So if you look at this per customer, what you can see is that each of the customer has a time window, and you can see that the vehicles that arrive to that customer arrive within the time window and depart within the time window. So that means that we're not arriving too early or too late, and there's nobody there to open the door or close the door. So how does it look like in code? So let's go back to the code here. We go here into vehicle routing with time windows, and let's take a look at the domain classes. So the domain is classes are basically what's coming in as JSON, right? So the data comes in as a JSON file, we solve it, and we send it back as a JSON file. And in these domain classes, we have a location, for example. You can see that's a latitude and a longitude, and it has a bit of JSON annotations to make sure our JSON looks pretty. So we have a depot, which is at a certain location. We have a vehicle, which is at a certain depot and which has a certain departure time. In this case, most of them start at, what time was it? They start at, I guess, 7 o'clock, all right? And then, of course, we have a list of customers. Now, the list of customers is actually special because this is the part that we're deciding with Timefold. So we're telling Timefold, in this vehicle class, that's a planning entity. That's something Timefold that you can change, all right? And we're telling Timefold also the customer list, that's the particular field you can change. So you can choose from us, for us, which customer which customers each vehicle will visit and which order they will do that. And that's exactly why this is called a planning list variable, because it changes during planning. It changes when we press that solve button, which you've seen in the UI. Then, of course, we have our customers, and our customers have a name, have a location, they have a ready and a due date. So the ready date is when the time windows opens. We cannot start work before the ready date. The due time is when the time windows end. We need to be departed there before the due time actually starts. And then we have a service duration. How long does it take to do the task at that particular customer? The other stuff you see here is basically will be added automatically from Timefold. This is what we call shadow variables, the vehicle and so forth. As Timefold decides to put a customer in a customer's list of a particular vehicle, it will also make sure it puts the vehicle into that customer's vehicle field. And you can see later below here, you can actually see an annotation on that. You could put that on the field too, but in this case, apparently it's been put on the getter. So you can see here that's a shadow variable that does exactly that. So that might be the whole story. Let's take a look at the constraints. So there's two constraints. And the constraints basically mean we get the data in, and then when we solve it, the constraints will make sure that we wanted to solve in a certain way or another way. So here we have the service finished after due time constraint, which makes sure that the service will never be finished after the due time. So here, let's take a look at how that's implemented. We have a customer. If it's the service is finished after due time, then we're going to penalize that as a hard constraint. We're actually going to penalize the delay in minutes. If we're 5 minutes over time, that's 5 points of hard constraints lost. But if we actually are 2 hours over time, that will be 120 minutes. All right. So let's take a look at how that's implemented. If we jump into that thing, so that's basically a customer here. We have the that function. Is service after due time. It just checks, is the arrival time filled in? And if the arrival time is filled in, we're going to add the service duration, and that's basically the departure time. We're going to check if that's after in due time. So once at the arrival time, how does that get filled in? Because remember, we're not telling Timefold when each customer, when the vehicle will arrive there, because we don't know that. That's a decision based upon Timefold. But on the other hand, Timefold is not deciding the arrival time. Timefold is deciding which customer a vehicle will visit and which order. And the arrival time is actually a calculation of that. So we call that again a shadow variable, but in this case, it's a custom shadow variable. So what you will see here, if you look at the get arrival time, you will see there's a shadow variable annotation on that. And we're saying basically, we want to update the arrival time every time Timefold changes the order in which a vehicle goes to certain customers. So if we now jump into the into this listener, all right, what you will see here is, let's close this and close this. So you will see that this listener listens every time when a customer changes, it will get an event. And I'm not going to go through the entire code here. There's documentation on that, of course, but I'll just show you the most important thing here. It will calculate the arrival time for each customer based upon the departure time of the previous customer. And so what it will do is, it will just say, okay, if these things are not filled in, let's put them to null. It's important to clean up sometimes. But I will say I'll take the departure time from the previous location, and I will add the seconds it takes to drive from the previous customer to the new customer, and that will be the new departure. So that will need me the arrival time at a new customer. And it will actually not just every time one of the customers gets moved to another vehicle or another order in that vehicle, it won't just do that for that, but also for all of the customers after that that customer. And that's why you have the while loop in here, which basically goes through all of the customers and the rest of the chain and make sure their arrival time is nicely updated. So we can, in the constraints, we can simply say, we can simply check if the arrival time is good for us. So basically, based upon the arrival time, we can figure out the departure time, we can figure out if the departure time is not after the due time. And the other thing we're going to do is we're going to minimize the travel time. So minimize travel time is a very basic constraint. You might have seen that in our other videos too. Basically, we simply say we go through all of the vehicles, we sum the total driving time in seconds, and we penalize that, all right? And as we have these constraints active, we basically get a solution where we stick to a hard constraints of the time windows, and we at the same time minimize the total travel time. So I hope you liked this solution. If you want to try it out, go to our website, clone the Quickstart repository, and just play with it.